structure. And this is something that the committee had asked for in their survey group. So, treasurer's come along to do that presentation.
Good morning, everybody. My name's John Fogarty. I'm the Director of Corporate Resources for the Combined Authority, but effectively the Combined Authority Treasurer. The report that you had in the past, as you see, is quite factual. It gives you where we're on up to with certain senior posts and recruitment. It's the information really that relates to formal decisions that have already been taken, either by the CA or appointments and display your panel. There's a presentation that I wanted to give that fully develops this a little bit more. Some of the points that you have picked up with Rotherham, this presentation picks up.
Sure, before we do that, is this part of your item? It says absolutely it's confidential. Oh, sorry, I missed it now.
Okay, is that?
Yeah.
Right, okay. Apologies for that. Anyway, this presentation really is a little bit more about the structure, more than is in the report in terms of where the structure is headed. But it picks up some of those budget points and funding and running costs. And I pick up those nearer to the end of this presentation. Some of the points that Steve addressed I can develop a little bit further. Okay, just a brief history because it's relevant to where we're at now. Obviously the CA didn't start with the election of the Metro Mayor. It started back in 2014-15. But in that first year there was very little in terms of real additional costs. The main functions of that combined authority were conducted by Mersey Travel, which was a transport remit, and Knowsley for the employment skills. Beyond transport and employment skills in that first year, it really was just a strategic decision-making body. But then we started to attract funding as a combined authority area. So there was local growth fund, LGF1 and LGF2, really big program of work that started in that first year, but didn't really get going in terms of spades in the ground in that first year. So obviously year one of the structure was very light in terms of cost. Moving on to the second year, which it was the CA really involving into what you would recognise as the Combined Authority now. The LGF programme delivery picked up quite significantly. Halton Curve, Newton Willow Station, Wigle North, as you mentioned, Ostrom, all of these were either developed or initiated in that year. We also attracted additional responsibilities for employment skills, economic development, highways and housing through the sort of next generation of the devolution deal. We had these immediate requirements for programme management and financial management related to the growth fund, and also the single investment fund, which has just been referred to. The city region decided to pool that devolved funding and issue a call for projects that wanted support from this single investment fund. That started in June 2016, $185 million. It was really obvious at that point that the combined authority could no longer continue just with Mersey Travel providing a financial accountable body function, Knowsley providing the employment and skills function, and basically all the districts seconding or lending staff with relevant expertise. The combined authority was becoming a really big beast, needs to have its own structures. To that extent, you'll be aware there was a report on capacity back in June 2016, which gave some idea of what a structure might look like that would provide the capacity to deliver the devolution deal. that was built into the budget for last year. Many of the posts associated with that report were filled, but not the key strategic posts, the most visible posts. They were deliberately left pending the election of the Metro Mayor, because clearly whoever became the Metro Mayor would have a really big say in what they wanted their strategic, their structure to look like. But all the operational functions were filled and were maintained in that 2016-17. You've seen the cost of that as well. Even without a fully fulfilled structure in the 16-17 year, the running costs of the combined authority were about £3.5 million. You'll see that from the published final accounts. That moves us into the current year. So, Mayor Rotherham has had a look at what he wants from the senior structure and recommended to the combined authority, who accepted it in August, a much leaner management team than was originally anticipated. So there's significant savings in the management team. They're not savings that you can bank, because none of those posts were filled anyway. It's just we had a report that suggested that there would be a director, for example, for each of the disciplines of the combined authority. Mayor Rotherham thinks that the combined authority continue with a more concentrated structure, which I'll come to. We also looked at the assumptions in the previous reports and budget, and I've worked, just myself, but Frank Rogers, the interim head of paid service, sat with Steve long times and looked at how we could use economies of scale to minimise particularly the support costs, but other costs as well. To come up with a structure that really only had the additional requirements, the additional posts that we needed for devolution and to fulfil the new responsibilities. So we lean in very heavily in the existing structure on resources at the left for economic regeneration, and particularly Mersey Travel. So Mersey Travel not just for transport, as you would imagine, but also for the support services. Financial services were appropriate. So as I'll come to, there's a current leadership team of four, and two of that leadership team have been in post since the election. Frank Rogers as interim head of paid service, and myself as treasurer. My post effectively is probably a good indication of how Mersey Travel and the CA have become closer together. I have been the Director of Finance at Mersey Travel for a number of years. Part of that role has always been to act as the Treasurer for the Combined Authority. So I've performed both roles since 2014. It's just got to a position now where the Combined Authority role probably takes precedent over the Mersey Travel role, and the job description has just changed to reflect that. But there are two directors of finance, it's still one for Mersey Travel and the combined authority. That's been quite, that approach has filtered down through a lot of the other support services as well. So instead of having two, there's just one that serves both bodies. So instead of, you know, having to have two directors or two heads of finance, you have the same one. You may need to, but we need to build capacity underneath, but it's often more. Obviously a lot more effective, there's a lot more economies of scale that can be delivered. Steve Rotherham has been very keen on that. A couple of other posts at the senior level which we'll come to, and they're in the report. One's been appointed to and will start after he's worked in the notice period, March, April time. And then there is another post where the final round of interviews is in, I believe, February 14th. So that structure should be in place. What I hope to demonstrate though is that an awful lot of the structure underneath those senior posts is there, because we couldn't continue without it. There are a number of posts that still need to be developed, but a lot of the, I'd call the engine room of the combined authority, is there. I'll just press that in. This is really a functional diagram. This is a functional diagram, really, which isn't quite a structured chart, but it's showing basically where the combined authority, the borough combined authority, how the structure's made up. So obviously, you've got at the top the elected city region mayor, who needs the chief executive. Again, the chief executive role's been fulfilled by Frank Rogers, whose substantive post, as you'll know, is the MD of Mersey Travel Chief Exec, who's fulfilling both roles at the moment. Just moving down, if you look at that side, one of the areas where we've been able to take quite a bit of cost out of previous assumptions is on the economic development side, which is to work with the LEP and look at ways in which the combined authority and the LEP can work jointly within a more streamlined management structure. And that's really maximised the benefit of the LEP and minimise the additional resources that the combined authority needs to deliver its economic regeneration side of the portfolio. Moving then next to that, you have transport. Other than you've got Frank covering both roles at the moment, that transport is fully populated. Mersey Travel exists. The Mersey Travel leadership team is in place. Original assumptions for transport were that the combined authority would have quite a significant transport strategy, transport policy, capacity of its own. It was seen as being quite separate from Mersey Travel. Again, sat with Steve, that's not the approach that we want, it doesn't make sense. We're going to lean on Mersey Travel for that transport expertise and Mersey Travel's equivalent in Halton, because Mersey Travel doesn't deliver transport in Halton at the moment. The only additional post then that the combined authority need to deliver its transport aims at the moment are only related to the extra powers. So they're related to the key route network and highways and freight and logistics. So they're basically down to two additional posts for transport rather than previous assumptions, which was quite significantly more. Corporate Services Directorate is my own, where I'm the Director of Corporate Services. I've got 151 responsibility or equivalent for both Mersey Travel and the Combined Authority. Beneath that is going to be there is a finance function that can serve both. It needs more capacity, but it doesn't need more managers. It needs to be having more qualified accountants, because clearly the numbers that we're looking after are significantly higher. It's a significantly different type of funding we need to manage. Managing capital programs is different than managing revenue programs, which Mersey Travel's finance team were based on. So we are bringing in skills and we're bringing in capacity. Exactly the same with the legal side of it. And then there are economies of scale then between Mersey Travel and the Combined Authority in areas such as committee services and executive PA support. And we'll have great benefit from those. In addition, you'll see in there that there's a dedicated role to support scrutiny. Anticipated within that structure as well. That Director of Corporate Services then, we think, pretty confident that we can fulfil all those roles for the Combined Authority with 9 additional posts rather than fulfil all, repopulate all those structures, one for the CA and one for Mersey Travel. Within that as well, the Combined Authority will be able to have access to IT services, HR services, payroll services, on kind of a service level agreement basis, internal audit with Mersey Travel. Again, it's a much cheaper model than would be the alternative. Then you've got essentially the two new areas of policy and commissioning and commercial development and investment. These are where we, and where Rotherham is quite keen that the resources are put into place sufficient to deliver the devolution agenda. I mean, put simply, you have a Director of Policy and Commissioning who would perform a role of being able to find out what the city region wants to do, and what sources of funding are available, attract money into the combined authority, you've got a director of commercial development and investment, whose role is to make the best use of those investments from a really hard-edged commercial perspective. These are new functions to us, and they'll need to be appropriately resourced. At the moment, a lot of the policy development around devolution has been done with the assistance of the City Region. The City Region Chief Executive leads on each of these areas. The Employment and Skills Team, who's heading up the Employment and Skills Team, they are in post, there's 11 of those. Those 11 posts, though, they are cost to the Combined Authority, as will each of the roles within that policy and commissioning will be an investment by the Combined Authority in that earlier. And the Director of Commercial Development, likewise, the significant staffing within that area. There already is quite a significant team of programme managers. You need that programme management office. It supports all your project managers and project sponsors for all your LGF schemes, all your CIF schemes. But it's going to be a much bigger scale once the single investment fund starts making investments that aren't being led by local authorities, that have been led by private companies or third sector organisations. We still have to have the same discipline, we still have to make sure they're delivering. So the programme management office itself will probably be at least 15, but it's already a significant team of maybe 11. Rotherham, again, is anxious that there is resources that are dedicated to sustainable energy, tidal energy, but also pipeline development. Again, as Steve just stressed, we will lose out if we don't have schemes that are ready to just stop and go. If we can't put our hand up when government says, are you ready, the money will just flow elsewhere. Again, at the other side of the structure, you have a mayoral advisor. The mayoral advisor's in post, and the mayor's office has been populated also. Head of communications in the Commons office too. We've got people in there who are fulfilling those roles already. What that comes down to in terms of a full-time equivalence, it is at the moment, this is subject to the budget next week. It's also subject to the new policy and commissioning having to say on their own structure. But you're looking at a net additional post of about 66 on top of the posts that are already in the Combined Authority. And again, for budget terms, there's already a significant cost in the Combined Authority. Combined Authority will spend 6 million quid this year on its running costs. So the budget for next year is 6.2 million. It's not an extra 6 million next year that's been asked for. It's a recognition of how the 6 million that's been spent, a lot of it's been spent with third parties, it's been spent by districts recharging the Combined Authority for the work that districts have done, quite rightly. But there's other costs within the premises and transport, supplies and services, all the natural costs that get picked up at your own organisations. That's the compressive money. Very briefly, this diagram is supposed to express what the Combined Authority's budget process looks like. It's trying to simplify it. Unfortunately, the colours haven't reproduced very well. But basically, this is income. The CA, as you'll see when you see the budget paper, and again, we'll do some work with on additional training on the budget for yourselves. I think that's been, I was asked that. That we can organise that, absolutely. But the CA gets income from the government, grants, a rail grant, local growth funding. It also gets income from the tunnels, and it also gets income from the transport levy, which each of the districts pay. Now, the top one, the grants, the CA has limited, we have influence, but we can't tell the government how much to give us. The other two are locally determined. They're within the budget. The additional new element of it this year is how you fund mayoral costs, and Rotherham's mentioned that. That is a challenge. the grants we get from gain share, there's a small revenue element to it, but government's clear message is that needs to be invested in economic growth. It's it's the revenue element of that gain share that we need for employment skills, business growth, work with apprentices, cultural programme. Those type of schemes that come forward from those areas don't tend to be capital. They're not about building infrastructure, they're about investing in people. So you need your revenue for that. Thus far, we've been able to balance it and spend some of that government grant on running costs, but government have been quite strong with us and said, whilst you can do that, you are really significantly putting at risk any future awards. And the 30 million isn't 30 million for 30 years. That's how the government presents it. It's 30 million for 5 years. And if you've complied with the conditions of that first 5 years, then you get it for another 5 years. So there's break clauses at every point that we need to be very aware of. And then clearly the CA takes account its income and then works out its expenditure from there. And again, in terms of size, the MERS running costs are a very small proportion of the overall budget. Mersey Travel Funding is the greatest proportion of that by far. So that's funding that the CA gives Mersey Travel for its public transport remit, operating the Mersey tunnels, and also the Mersey Rail Network, which has been devolved to us. You know, together those three are probably 220, 230 million pounds a year. So the budget process is a lot more than just the CA's running costs. But clearly the CA running cost is the new element of it this year, or the MERA running cost, which has attracted obviously quite a lot, quite rightly, a lot of attention, a lot of scrutiny. The budget then for this year, as you'll see, will be based on that structure that just described, but also provides some capacity to develop tidal energy, digital connectivity. For the MERA to look at his powers in terms of the bus network, which are new powers that have been devolved to us, see how the city region can make the best use of those powers. And also provide revenue funding for a number of task and finish pieces of work that still need to be done. Clearly we need to invest in future devolution, or again the region will lose out, and also fund these transport responsibilities that I just mentioned. So there is a significant revenue package in place that's been funded through government grants, of course the CIF, through the transport levy and through other income. But the Mayor has been very anxious to minimise the burden on local taxpayers, so it's pressure not to put the transport levy up. Obviously the transport levy's gone down very significant the last 3 years, but also there's been the discussion around the precept and how you fund running costs. In a way, the running costs themselves, adding up how much it's going to cost, is the easy bit. The difficult bit obviously is how you finance that. So the finance order is quite explicit. It says the cost of a MERA in a combined authority that are incurred in with the exercise of the new MERA functions are to be met by a precept issued by the authority, etc. The second paragraph of that says unless they can be met in other ways. So the precept is for those costs that you can't meet through other means. Now, we have been able to work out for next year a package with each of the districts that means that you don't need to switch the preset power on this year because we've found other ways to fund it. That funding package has been teased out with each of the leaders of the districts. It's not a bold in a technical sense. It's not a subscription. It's very much an investment in the single investment fund, which will allow us as a CA to take revenue out of the single investment fund to fund running costs for a year, but make sure there's no detriment to the fund, because effectively the districts are going to topple the fund and you're going to do that as an investment in the future. As the fund grows, there'll be a financial benefit flowing back from that fund to each of the districts who've had a hand in funding that. It does demonstrate the commitment that the districts have got to the city region and the confidence that they've got in the fund itself. But more importantly, it has allowed, as my brother said, not to switch on that preset power in the current year, because it's not something that the mayor or the combined authority want to do this year, in recognition of all the other pressures upwards on council tax bills. So there will be a piece of work this year based on looking at a sustainable and affordable model to balance that conundrum. We spent last year looking at the capacity that we need. We found a way of funding it. This year we need to find a way of funding it into the future. That is the limit of the presentation, but obviously you'll have questions. I'm happy to answer as best that I can.
So, John, there's any questions, Councillor Thomas?
Thank you, Chair. Thank you for the presentation, John. I agree with you that trade and working to minimise resources is a great thing. However, as the President said, there's a risk of conflict of interest. How are you mitigating the potential conflict of interest?
Well, the conflict of interest, I guess, arises if we consider Mersey Travel as a separate body from the combined authority. Mersey Travel is still a separate statutory body. They've still got powers in the passenger transport executive, but they are very much the combined authority is very much the controlling mind of all of the combined authority, including Mersey Travel. It's not a great analogy, because there's two ways to think about it. Each have got technical problems with it. The one that I prefer, because it's my background also, is combined authority is like a local authority, and Mersey Travel is its transport department. Another way of looking at it is that Mersey Travel is a wholly owned subsidiary of the combined authority. So it's the combined authority management teams making decisions on resources for Mersey Travel. It's not Mersey Travel making financial decisions for the combined authority. So we will act as one body at a strategic level at the top. Mersey Travel director, IND, will be on the combined authority's management team, but won't be making decisions separately from the combined authority. And also, the combined authority as a group of members will have visibility of all the decisions that are taken. There'll be a scheme of delegation, etc., that will flow through. Oh, does that address what I think you're asking?
So,
thanks, Jeff. Hey, John, thanks for that. Nice to see you.
Chair of the LEP sits on the combined authority, so that's where this arises from. We have a close relationship with the LEP, but the LEP is still an independent body. Other combined authority areas have fully incorporated the LEP into the combined authority structure. That's not the case here, but we are very close to them. Where we'd be leaning on the LEP in terms of strategy, is in terms of strategy at the high level and management rather than operationally within that structure. It's so that the city region can speak with one voice in growth strategies, employment strategy. On your second point around scrutiny of the LEP, I guess each of your district leaders sit on the LEP board. LEP board governance isn't something I'm hugely involved in. Having said that though, the piece of work that was done by government who reviewed LEPs this year has made certain recommendations about how combined operators work with LEPs. That might be something that is worth, perhaps as that conversation develops, it's very new. But there has been some government guidance that we're working with the LEP in how best we satisfy that. There'll be an outcome from that piece of work. It could be something that we bring back to here. I think it sounds like something that is going to be a lot of benefit in looking at as that conversation develops. There's a budget paper that's going to come out tomorrow. We'll have more detail on that. We don't want to preempt that budget paper or preempt the decision. But yes, the anticipation is that, that each of the districts will all benefit from economic growth and growth in those investments. It's something that each of districts were very keen to express in the budget through this round of negotiations. The budget papers will come out tomorrow, probably got more detail, and each of that detail needs to be backed up in your own budget papers. I don't want to anticipate how each of the districts will articulate that transaction in your own budget. That's an issue for each of the districts, so I'm trying to limit this to speaking on behalf of the combined authority and not.
Sure, Chair, so just some cards that you've got as important recommendations for that money will sit in the same what the districts give it will not eventually come back to the local authority to start the transaction.
Oh no, the anticipation is that I'll come back to local authorities, yeah. It's an investment, it's not a subscription.
Thanks, Joe. Sorry, just a quick, can we have a copy of that presentation?
Yes, certainly, yeah, possible.
Awesome. It would be good just to share that through you if we could get copies of things before the meeting. That's not all the report, everything we've had today has been available all day. We don't get too much time ahead of the meeting to look through.
Potential requirement for reset.
could be something that, is looked at for a future round of devolution. The issue that, we've got, or that my brother-in-law's got with that, is that if we, we have to have a conversation with government around freedoms and flexibilities, financial freedoms and flexibilities, where we're seeking more devolved powers in terms of the revenue we can raise locally through taxation or different types, etc. That's the end game. Government stance would be that we've given you certain freedoms and flexibilities already. If you don't use them, as other areas are using them, then it's hard to get traction when we're having those conversations if we're not using the ones that we've got. So it's a balance of, it's exactly as Rotherham said, we've got to balance what we're getting out of the combined authority with what with the sense of what we're putting into it. But at the moment, that does give us, the order does give us flexibility, and we are employing that flexibility for at least another year, not to set a preset. However, it does make it very difficult to spend government's money on things that government would wish a preset to be used instead. So we constructed, we have to work with the districts on this. With the combined authority and the district really have to work together and have to go through this budget process. Yeah, there will be. We're working that through the directors of finance.
Agenda, if there's any other agent items.